Negeri Sembilan is located on the west coast of the peninsula of Malaysia, just south of Kuala Lumpur, and it's my home state. Negeri Sembilan was settled by the Minangkabau people from Sumatra in the 15th century, and they brought with them their culture, their distinctive architecture, their traditions, their language, and their food, all of which remain to this day. I grew up in the state capital of Seremban, which is a former tin mining town, and my parents used to be hawkers before my family upgraded to selling snacks at the Odeon Cinema Canteen in Seremban. The dishes for which Seremban is famous include Seremban Siew Pao and Seremban Beef Noodles, both of which I used to make and sell in my restaurant here in Sydney. Malay food in Negeri Sembilan uses a generous amount of bird's eye chilies or cili api, so it tends to be very spicy. Some famous Malay dishes include Negeri Sembilan style beef rendang, daging salai, which is a smoked meat, and also masak lemak cili api.
Today we are going to Negeri Sembilan, one of the states in the peninsula of Malaysia. And there are a lot of attraction in Negeri Sembilan, but I have choose three most important tourist attraction that you must visit when you come to Negeri Sembilan.
So I'm going to show you how to make Seremban beef noodles in this episode, but the type of noodles used in the dish itself may not be that easy to come by depending on where you're located. So first up, I'm going to show you how to make the noodles yourself at home. So I'm gonna make some homemade rice noodles. And here I've got equal amounts of rice flour and starch. Tapioca starch would work. To that, we're going to add some water. It's boiling water. Now we're going to bring it together and knead it. Okay, so we're going to cook the noodles, and for that I've got a pot of boiling water here, I've got a bowl of cold water here, got these noodles, this noodle dough here, and then I've got this thing which is a noodle mold, right? I've put in the mold here, and I've got this that's going to just screw in and make the noodles for us. So with this, just grab a portion that you want. So boiling water on standby. Just screw in the mold. Put this in here. So there you go. under 20 minutes using just over 2 cups of flour, 1 each of tapioca flour, tapioca starch, and rice flour.
Seri Menanti Palace. This is one of the famous landmark in Negeri Sembilan. This is the last timber palace in the country. This palace is very special because it adopted the Minangkabau architecture and constructed without using any nails. So this is an attraction you must not miss because this is the last of the wooden palace in Malaysia.
Okay, so the next place we're going to is to get some Siew Pao. Personally, I don't really eat Siew Pao, but you know, a lot of people do, so I'm just going to pack some for my friends back home in KL. That's another thing about Asian culture, you know, you can't be heading out for a food tour, eating all that good food by yourself and going home empty-handed, right? That's just rude. Invited into the kitchen again. Here we go. Oh my goodness, you gotta see this, guys. You gotta see this. Let's say if it's fully cooked and all, how long do they last? How long can I keep it for?
Around 3 days.
3 days? Peng Leng Teng.
And this is cendol.
Thank you very much.
Don't look nice, but taste nice.
And this is the very kind man who actually, I've never met him before. He doesn't know that I'm actually going to be here today, but he literally just offered to let me walk into his kitchen and check out how he actually does his siew pao. All fresh, no preservatives. Amazing. See ya. Two big bags. How could I say no, man? And he actually gave him some freebies too. So that's actually quite always welcome. Freebies are welcome.
So we're going to make Ngau Lam Fun, which is famous in Seremban. You probably won't be able to find Ngau Lam Fun anywhere else apart from Seremban. So there are stories of people traveling from Singapore and making a special detour to Seremban just to eat Ngau Lam Fun. Okay, so first of all, I've got some beef brisket that I've cut into strips here, and also I've got some beef bones. So with the beef bones, we're going to make a stock and soup with it. If you have chicken bones as well, you should add to this, okay? I do not today, I'm only using beef bones. And you can simmer this for a few hours, or you can cheat like me and use your pressure cooker. So this is just the beef bones in some water. We're going to pressure cook it. So I've got some beef brisket here. I've cut them into strips. And we are going to add some marinade ingredients to it. Bit of pepper, sugar, bit of 5 spice powder, bit of salt or chicken powder, thick soy sauce, light soy sauce, sesame oil. We're gonna cheat and transfer this into a pressure cooker. Add a little bit of water. So while we were waiting for the soup and for the beef brisket to pressure cook, we can prepare some of the other stuff that go with this dish, including roasting some sesame seeds, frying up some peanuts. These are peanuts with the shell on. And slicing some what we call in Chinese ham choy, and what you usually find sold as salted mustard leaves at your Asian grocery store. So have a look for them. These come in like small packets, and you rinse it and then you slice it thin. Okay, so now we have the beef stock already. This is what it looks like after half an hour in the pressure cooker. we're going to use some of it to make one of two sauces that go with this dish. What you want to do is saute some garlic. So we're just going to fry this till it's aromatic and lightly toasted. Add a little bit of oyster sauce to this, a bit of pepper, and beef stock. Add a bit of seasoning, a bit of salt or chicken powder. So this is the light sauce that goes on the noodles, and we want to just thicken it up now. Let me just reduce the heat a little bit. Get a bit of starch, we're using tapioca starch here. Mix with a bit of cold water. Just add it here. Okay, so that's the first sauce. Now, this is the beef that's been pressure cooked with all the marinade. So what we're doing now, we're just braising this till the marinade is absorbed, some of it at least anyway, and the beef is tender. Now what we're going to do, we're going to take out some of the beef marinade and make the second sauce with it while the beef is braising in the sauce. So let's take some of this out and we'll let this cook on low heat. So while the beef continues to braise on low heat, we've taken some of the marinade and we're going to make a second sauce to go with the noodles. So let's heat up this pan again. Bit of oil, garlic. So we're just sizzling the garlic till it's aromatic and slightly toasted. And we're going to add the marinade from the beef. Add a bit of seasoning. A bit more sugar. And then what we want to do is just thicken it up a little bit. Get some tapioca starch. So this is your second sauce, and I'm just going to dish it up. So as you braise the beef, you can see it just start to develop like a shiny sheen, and you want the liquid to reduce till it's thickened. This is kind of like the equivalent of char siu or barbecued meat, but with beef. So it's meant to taste a bit sweet. Okay, so this is what it looks like. And ideally you want to let this cool down a little bit and then you slice it up. Okay, so let's cut up some of the beef. And let's assemble the noodles. The noodles you would blanch in hot water before using, but because this was just cooked fresh, I'm just going to use it straight. Put beef on. If you have tripe, you will be putting the tripe on as well. So we've got the two types of sauces. This is the dark sauce. This is the light sauce. Then you've got the salted vegetables, salted mustard leaves, sesame seeds, peanuts. There you go. You would serve it with a side of beef broth, sprinkled with some spring onion. And when you finish the noodles, you can pour the broth into the bowl to lap up all the last bits of sauce and drink it from the bowl. Give it a go. Let me know how it turns out.
Sri Sendayan Mosque is situated in near the town of Seremban, the capital of Negeri Sembilan. It has won a lot of praises from the public for its elegant and artistic Islamic architecture. Some of the materials are flown in from Egypt, Turkey, Dubai and Morocco. And the best time to go is in the evening because the whole mosque is lighted up. It's so beautiful at night.
Ooh, time for lunch. Look at the barbecue over there.
Nice.
Wow, look at this restaurant. We are in the kampung now. You can even see the traditional houses, wood houses.
Catfish?
Yeah.
And
sambal.
No,
this one is
smoky
anchovies with pad thai. You know pad thai?
No.
The stinky beans.
I got smoked beef, chicken, and rice, and one stinky bean. What'd you get, buddy?
Chicken.
Chicken.
Chicken sambal. Cow stomach.
Maybe we call it tripe.
And then also the anchovies together with the sticky beans.
Wow, looks good. Look at all this food.
Okay, first try.
Cow stomach. Have with rice. Feel nervous? Tastes fine. Tastes good.
The jelly.
Not bad at all. I was nervous. No, like jelly. Kind of squishy, like fat almost. It's not fat, it's muscle, but it's like, it's not bad at all. I was super nervous. I was like, oh God.
You're like Malaysian now. Trap is like normal for you. Stinky beans is normal for you.
Stinky beans wasn't that bad. You thought it was going to be exciting to watch. It was just normal.
Yeah, you're like a Malaysian.
It's just a flavorful bean, strong bean.
The
smoky beef is unreal. Like really good. I'm not sure about eating bamboo.
Oh, you're finished.
I'm flying through. No, I dumped it all here.
Oh, okay.
How about you try the sambal belacan?
I'm worried it's going to be shrimp. Is it shrimp flavor?
Yeah, shrimp flavor.
Okay. Might be too much fish. I try. I'm nervous it's going to be so fishy. Okay. Put some beef. Put some rice.
What is it?
Pretty good.
Good.
Not bad. I'm Malaysian now. There's no more food you can give me that's outrageous. Okay, maybe insects.
Everything
that's not Malaysian,
normal.
Maybe Thailand. But I'm getting used to more interesting food.
Nice.
I've been here for too long.
So we just found out that the food that we're eating is called nasi lemak. No, nasi lemak. Masak lemak cili api. Because the fish is cooking green chili sauce and the beef and the chicken there that Steve is having is also cooked in green chili sauce.
Yeah, it's quite spicy. My lips are tingling. But look, left hand perfectly clean.
Right.
Like a pro.
That's really good.
This ayam bakar, the best thing I've had all day. So good. But quite spicy.
There you go. Masak lemak chili api.
If you guys are ever in this area, you should definitely come to this restaurant. We'll show you the name. Although, where is this area? We're in
Pedas, Negeri Sembilan.
Pedas.
What do you mean spicy?
No kidding.
Yeah, spicy.
If you're ever in spicy, come here for some green chili food.
Okay guys, I'm going to show you how to make lempeng pisang. Okay, lempeng pisang is just like a pancake, but it is no baking powder, okay? And this is very popular in Negeri Sembilan, yeah, especially they serve it during tea time or breakfast, yeah. And this is the typical Negeri Sembilan delicacy. Sometimes you can also get it at the hawkers or by the street hawkers. It's lempeng pisang, okay? So lempeng is a pancake. So pisang is a banana, okay? Okay, look at this. It's so easy, right? After everything is done, so you just flip your banana leaf. So this is the lempeng. Ah, this is the lempeng pisang. So easy and nice. Look. Have you pisang? Oh, the smell. Yeah. The smell is so good. Good look. See, this is the texture. So nice with tea. Try this. Oh, I've been eating a lot today, but it's okay. I still want to try this because this will bring me back to memories. So good. So please try this simple recipe from me, Chef Ismail Ahmad from Restaurant Rebong, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. See you! Bye!
We are in Port Dickson. It's a town by the sea, and there's a lot of things to do here because the main attraction here is the beach. There's a lot of hotels and resorts in this area, and during weekends, there are thousands of domestic tourists will visit this beach in Port Dickson. And also in terms of food, there's a lot of restaurants serving seafood and local dish.
Okay, next stop. Gotta wash all this off with some cendol, man. Cendol first thing in the morning at 10:30 a.m. So we've got the famous rojak together with the cendol. Try. Okay, I want to try the cendol first. Let me just show you guys how it looks like. So, this is their famous cendol. Oh, okay, it looks a bit watery actually. Cendol. You know, when I was a kid, I used to love cendol. Then I started getting fat from it, right? Then I had to sort of like ease off in the cendol. Here's what I can tell you about the cendol. Okay, it looks pretty fresh. It has to be fresh, right? Now it's like 10:30 in the morning and I'm having like a rojak and a cendol. Second breakfast. It's good. The balance between the palm sugar and the coconut milk, it's okay. I want to try the rojak next. Let me show you what's inside the rojak. Okay, so in the rojak itself, you've got an egg, another egg, right? This is like probably my third or fourth egg this morning. And then it's got your usual cucumbers, and then smothered with the sauce, this is the tofu. And then it's got, does it have bean sprout on this one? Okay, yes, it does. It has bean sprout. And yeah, pretty much all shredded in. So again, when it comes to this sort of food, what makes or breaks it is actually the sauce, which you're going to find in a while. First taste. It's also on the spicy side. Wow. It seems that in the Negeri Sembilan, everything is extra spicy. But not in a bad way, it's nice. Wicks you up.